So the drain condition means the drainage is available. So whatever the soil below the groundwater table, when any load is applied, there is a drainage available. So the free flow of water through the soil is available. So in this condition, we are not going to consider it as a fully saturated both layers. So this will be dry and this is considered saturated. So we are going to calculate separately for this and separately for this. So for the 1 meter and for the 3 meters. So as it is a drain condition, water is allowed to move out of the soil. So now the soil above the groundwater table is considered as dry. Soil below the groundwater table is considered as saturated. So for this, the distribution diagram will be almost same. So due to the load, this is QKP. Due to cohesion, this is 2C dash root KP. Why I used C dash here? So this is drain condition. So 2C dash root KP. The only one logic here you need to understand is, so there is a groundwater table at this condition. So when the stress increase with depth, when the stress increase with depth, it will increase up to constantly up to groundwater table, and after this, due to the pore water pressure, there will be change in the stress. So up to groundwater table, the stress increases like this, and below the groundwater table, there is a variation in the stress. So you have groundwater table here. So we need to calculate the total vertical stress above the groundwater table, and we need to calculate the total vertical stress below the groundwater table. Total vertical stress above the groundwater table, below the groundwater table. Generally, which is having pore water pressure, right? So we need to calculate effective stresses. We need to calculate effective stresses. I hope you remember the difference between total vertical stress and effective stress. Total vertical stress is, total vertical stress is only gamma H. Effective stress, effective stress is nothing but total vertical stress minus pore water pressure. This is the difference. Total vertical stress is gamma H. Effective vertical stress is total vertical stress minus pore water pressure. So above the groundwater table, pore water pressure is zero. Below the groundwater table, you need to consider pore water pressure. So there will be distribution diagram separately for the pore water pressure. The stress, the pore water pressure is U is equal to gamma W H W. Pore water pressure will be is U is equal to gamma W H W. Gamma W means unit weight of water. When you consider with gravity, unit weight of water will be 9.81. Height of groundwater table is 3 meter. So let us see it later. So this is the distribution diagram for the given condition of the soil profile in drained condition. In drained condition. Do you understand this? Only difference between the previous diagram and this diagram is above the groundwater table and below the groundwater table. So there is no shape for this, right? So when we are calculating, we are going to consider, I am just dropping the total stress, I am dropping the stress, effective stress here. So we are going to calculate the submerged stress up to this point. We are going to calculate the submerged stress here. This is only the transferring of the effective stress above the groundwater table. How you calculate effective stress above the groundwater table? Gamma H Kp, because it is a dry unit weight, gamma h Kp. When you calculate the effective stress below the groundwater table, it is also gamma h Kp, but we cannot consider gamma as dry weight here, as it is submerged, as it is saturated. Gamma sat minus pore water pressure into h into Kp. Only the new logic is here. This is, as it is submerged below the groundwater table, we need to consider gamma sat. So gamma sat minus pore water pressure, because it is effective stress. Gamma sat minus pore water pressure. This is simple like this. Sigma dash b h Kp. Effective stress. Effective stress is total vertical stress minus pore water pressure. So this is the distribution diagram. So from this diagram, now you need to calculate the total passive earth pressure. We need to calculate total passive earth pressure. Total passive earth pressure will be A1 plus A2. So consider this as A1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. A1 plus A2 plus A3, A4, A5 and A6. A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 and A6. Now we need to calculate separately, or you can calculate together, but it will be very clear if you do it separately. So let us start doing passive earth pressures for individual diagram. So when I consider the first section, A1 is half base into height, right? Half gamma h Kp into h. 0.5 dry unit weight, gamma 19 h. What is the h for the first one? 1 meter. What is Kp? You need to calculate Kp. Just calculate Kp is equal to tan square 45 plus pi dash by 2. Tan square 45, pi dash is 30 over 2. So this will be tan square 60. Please tell me the value of tan square 60. Three. So in this condition, when the phi value is 30 degrees, the value of Kp is equal to 3. So for this condition, for the drain condition, the value of Kp is 3. So gamma h Kp into height. What is height again? 1 meter above the groundwater table. 1 meter above the groundwater table. It is 28.5 kilonewton per meter. So please listen, while calculating for A2, please try to understand this. So above the groundwater table, the effective stress, or the stress, is the maximum stress gamma h Kp above the groundwater table. Below the groundwater table, it extends from here. Below the groundwater table, again it is varying, right? So just transfer the maximum stress to the ground, to the bottom. Just transfer the maximum stress to the bottom. Submerged stress we are calculating here, because gamma sat minus gamma w into this one. Submerged stress is calculated here. This is only the pictorial representation to transfer the maximum stress above the groundwater table here. HKP, can you please calculate only gamma HKP? It is 19 into 1 into 3, 57. So this is 57 into height. What is the height for the second one?
3.
So I think it's 171 kilonewton over meter. Actually, in the last previous class, we have a lot of discussion on this. Why you are not considering the gamma sat when it is below the groundwater table? The question asked was, why you are not considering gamma sat here? Why you are considering only gamma here? We are not calculating stresses in this area. We are not calculating stresses, and this is not the stress diagram. This is the submerged stress and this is the dry stress. In the above the groundwater table, this is the value for stress. Below the groundwater table, submerged stress is calculated here. This is only the transfer of the dry weight of the soil stress to the bottom, because this load is going to act here. This load is going to act here. Whatever the load or whatever the stress coming onto the soil is this. So that's why this is 57 into 3 A2. Right? Then if you have, I think we have done it in the previous classes also. Just the base into height. 57 into 3. Is it clear? So now it's all easy now. A3 half. What is base? Gamma sat minus gamma W HKP. So this is base into height. So this will be 0.5 into, what is gamma sat? 21. Unit weight of water 9.81. H is 3 below the groundwater table. KP is 3 and H is 3. Solve this. I think it's 151.065 kilonewton over meter. Can you calculate A4 and A5? Are you clear with A3? A4 to C dash root KP into H. C dash is 3 kilonewton per meter square, KP is root 3, H is 3 or 4?
4.
In the 4th section, height is 4, so there is no groundwater effect, so total height 4 meters. So 2 C dash root KP into H, 2 into 3 into root 3 into 4. A5 is Q KP into H. Q is 25, KP is 3, H is 4. How much A4?
41.5
kilonewton per meter. A5? A5, 25,300. Do you understand A4 and A5? A6. A6 is half base into height. 0.5 gamma W 9.81 into 3 into 3. 29.43 into 3 into 0.5. I think it's 44.14 something.
44.14
kilonewton per meter. Do you understand how to calculate A1, A2, A3, A4, A5? Everything is clear. Only one point generally where we got more discussion here is, this is just the transfer of the stress to this point. We are not calculating any stress. Above the groundwater table, the maximum effective stress is this. Below the groundwater table, the submerged condition is calculated here. In this portion, we are calculating the submerged effective stress, gamma sat minus gamma w into h into kp. This is just the transfer of the maximum stress here to the base. So that's why we consider the base as 57 and the height as 3 meters. So in this condition, it is 57 into 3. So once you are done with this, please calculate the PP, total passive earth pressure, A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5 plus A6. It is 736.27 kilonewton per meter. Now it is required to find out the position of the passive earth pressure from the bottom. For the first, it will be from the bottom, h plus h by 3. Please understand this. When you are calculating the location of the pressure for the first section, it should be from the bottom. For triangle, it is h by 3. From the bottom, this is h. So, A1 into h plus h by 3. This is only the important thing in this. I hope you understand. Why h plus h by 3? It is here. For this portion, the location of the pressure is h by 3. But from the bottom, h plus h by 3 plus A2 into h by 2 plus A3 h by 3, because it is a triangle. A3 h by 3, A4 h by 2, A5 h by 2, now A6 h by 3 again, right? A1 triangle and it is on the top, from the bottom it is h plus h by 3, A2 rectangle h by 2, A3 triangle h by 3, A4 h by 2, A5 h by 2, A6 h by 3, because pore water pressure over PP, over total passive earth pressure. So what will be this? So h plus h by 3, 3 plus 1 by 3, h2, h is 3, 3 by 2, for area, for A2 it is h by 2, 3 by 2, A3, 3 by 3, A4, now it is total height, 4 by 2, A5, 4 by 2, A6, pore water pressure is only 3, not 4, so this is again 3 by 3. So please calculate A1, 3 plus 1 by 3, A2, 3 by 2, A3, 3 by 3, A4, 4 by 2, A5, 4 by 2, A6, 3 by 3, over total passive pressure. Please calculate and tell me the answer. The bottom is 736.27, the top one is 1229.73, isn't it?
Yes.
So as I told you in the previous, the unit will be meter, 1.67 meter. So this is the location, this is the location. If you want to show it on for the diagram, from the bottom, the passive earth pressure, from the bottom, the passive pressure is acting at 1.67 meter. From the bottom, the passive pressure is acting at 1.67 meter. So this is the passive earth pressure problem. Whatever the question is given, you have to do first for undrained condition. You can do it as it is up to you, brain, unbrained, whatever it is. So let us start with unbrained condition. What is the logic in the unbrained condition? If it is an unbrained condition, as the surcharge is acting, we assume the whole soil is saturated, because above the groundwater depth it is only 1 meter. 1 meter is only very this much only maximum. So this much soil, we assume that there is a chance of water rising up. So we consider all the layer as saturated. That is the only basic logic in that. So gamma sat you consider 21 kilonewton over meter cube. In the drained condition, you have separated above the groundwater table and below the groundwater table. You calculated the effective stress above the groundwater table separately. The submerged condition, effective stress, you calculated separately and you have done the whole process. So the passive earth pressure for undrained condition it is 1.908 meter. For drained condition it is 1.67 meter. So you need to find out three here. The first one is you need to draw the correspond analysis diagram. The first portion is analysis diagram. Diagram have very good marks, almost 1/3 marks. Diagram, analysis diagram. Then you need to calculate the total passive pressure. Then you need to calculate location of the pressure from the bottom. So there are 3 steps. First step, draw the analysis diagram in detail. Total passive pressure. Finally, location of the passive pressure, passive earth pressure.